Fathers and the Holy Spirit, one with me. As we started the first thing of Nativity, the Church during this period of time is focusing on the Incarnation and focus on why Christ came from heaven. And was he? Why he incarnate and he took a flesh? And one of the reasons why he created Adam and Eve, he created them because of his love. Because of his love. This is the most important reason for why God created Adam and Eve. And it said, many people said, God created Adam and Eve to serve him or to worship him. We said that God does not need a worship, does not create Adam and Eve and humanity and angel to glorify or praise him. He is full, he's in full divinity. He doesn't need, he's not shortcoming of a praising or glorification. But he created Adam and Eve because out of his love, as I mentioned before, is a couple loves each other so much and they incarnate this love into a baby. Not because they need help or they need someone to say mom or dad, but because of their love. They love each other so much they want to, like I said, make this love into something physical and showing created Adam and Eve. So God had the same concept. He created. And to the point that when he created them, he prepared everything in the beginning for them. But when once he created Adam and Eve, they will enjoy his presence. Not only enjoying his presence, but enjoying the nature, the creation of it. As the same concept when the mom is pregnant, so the whole family preparing a room, they have a baby shower to prepare everything for the baby until he comes, you find everything is ready for him. And the same concept, God created Adam with the same reason. When Adam and Eve followed in the disobedience, they got out of Garden of Eden. And they said when Adam and Eve, they ate from the fruit, they felt they are naked. And they living, we don't know how long been since the creation until the fall. We don't know exactly the time. But when they fall, they look at themselves and found they are naked. There's nothing changed in their clothes and they've been there this way since they created. But why this time they fell with the shame and shyness? And because of the sin when entered to the world and make the people feel this shy or the shame out of what they did. And they try to cover themselves with the leaves of the fig tree. But instead God was with them and say they make it fast and cover themselves quickly. So they look at the trees and found this fig tree has a big leaves, so they cut it and they sold something for them. But didn't work. So God, he looked at them and said, you know what, I love you. And I want to cover you from your sins. I want to cover you from your nakedness. That's why, what did he do in the beginning? He killed an animal and he took its skin and sewed a garment or dressing to cover their nakedness. That's why in the Catholic Con today in 1 Peter chapter 4, God
and inspired Peter, the Holy Spirit, to say these words. It said, and above all things, have fervent love for one another, for love will cover a multitude of sins. For love cover a multitude of sins. Love cover a multitude of sins. And this is our meditation today, my love. If the love of God covers their sins, not only cover them with the skin of the enemies, but later on cover them with his righteousness and his blood, with incarnation and crucifixion and the salvation. So what is the scenario of the salvation? The scenario of the salvation to cover the human from their nakedness and to get them out of their shyness and become with covered by his righteousness or his love to cover the multitude of sins. And the same concept, my beloved, today. When we read the story about Christ when he was in the earth, I'll do two examples quickly. Number one, we mentioned the prodigal son in Luke chapter 15. When the prodigal son came to him after he realized what's going on in his life, and he reached the reality that he lost everything and he wasted all his righteousness and the father's righteousness, so why did he come back to Christ or to his father? And while he was coming from far away, what his father did, he ran to him and he fell on his neck and covered him from his nakedness. And the son is thinking about my father, he will ask me, where is the money? He will ask me, he will judge me, what did he do with your money? What did he do with your position? You waste my name and you put my name into the ground and all this reputation and shame. But amazing, when Christ came, the good person came to him. He was what he covered him. And the same concept, why did he cover him? Because love covered multitude of sins. Love covered multitude of sins. And he looked at his, my smelling bad, I'm a prodigal son, I'm a very bad son. The love of Father will cover your sins, will cover your shortcomings, will cover your bad smells or bad behaviors. Why? Because the love covers multitude of sins. In the book of Mark chapter 1, our Lord Jesus Christ was walking around, and then there's a leprosy man. And from far away, he asked him, could you please heal me? I know you can. Would you please heal me? And then the Lord looked at him with compassion and reached out and touched him. Look at him with compassion. Reach it out and touch it him and say that, yes, I want you, Edward. We know that the leprosy, that people has leprosy, they have a curse and they are defiled. And by law, they have to be far from people at least 10 meters, almost like 30 feet. They have to shout. And it shaped for people that are telling them by sign and signals or by sign language. They can't reach, or maybe they can call far, or they can't come closer. Once they come closer, they will have everything they touch to be defiled, and anyone can pass by or touch them to be defiled. They have to do some period of time to clean themselves. But amazing Christ, he reached out. He looked at with compassion, reached out and touched him and said, but you made well. And the man looked at him, are you going to touch me? You don't know what's going to happen to you? You're going to get defiled.
I'm rejected from it, but no one can come and talk to me. No one come and touches me. No one is going to want to deal with me because I have leprosy. You are the one can come and touch me and talk to me. The Lord said, what? Yes. Because of what? Love covers multitude of sins. Because love covers multitude of sins. You don't care about my situation, my conditions. No. It doesn't matter your situation, it doesn't matter what you are, who you are, what have you done. It's coming towards me. It matters who I am. The Lord is full of love. That's why He wants to cover a multitude of sins. The lady who has a bleeding for 12 years. And then she put in her heart, if I go and touch his garment, I will be healed. I will be healed from all my affliction. So she had a multitude there, and the same concept, a bleeding woman has to be saying for her purity, for to be apart from the church, apart from the temple, apart from people, because there's going to be defilement for the others. So she can't touch anything. She can't touch anyone. She can't touch even the same concept of leprosy, but it's less risky or less low about her or good about her. And she went between the people there, and she touches many people while they're going to the reach Christ. She goes to her and she's a very crowd around Christ. But she put in her heart, she has a kind of conflict in her heart. I want to get healed. I want to get purified from my sin or from my sickness. I wasted all my money on medicine and physicians to get healed, but nothing, zero results. And the same thing about the defilement, the rules. I'm in conflict in between both, which one I'm going to go. I'm feeling guilty that I defile people around me. Do I go to Christ or not? There's certain rules to follow Christ. Do I follow the rules or not? And the lady, she came and finally she got the decision of touching Christ's garment. And she went there and said, and she touched him. And she knew in herself that she got healed from all her affliction, from all her disease. Stopped. Bleeding stopped. And then, amazing Christ, what happened to him? He looked around and said, who touched him? The disciples said, excuse me? Are you seeing all this crowd and you're asking who touched you? You have many crowds around you. You don't ask who touched me. It's 100 people around you. Yes. But there's a power that came out of me to heal people's sickness. And people, this lady, she touched me and I felt that the power came out of me. Why this power? The power of covering her sins or her sickness. The Lord understand this power came out of him to heal. To make this lady is not in shame anymore. Why Christ did you heal her? Why did you call her? Because love covers multitude of sins. But in reality, God exposed her, actually. God exposed her. When he told her, come where she is, and she came with fear and trembling. She understands that she did something very against the rules. Against the whole rules of the law. That she is leading untouched people. And then the Lord looked at her. My daughter, don't be afraid. Your faith made you wise. Go in peace. Excuse me. So why did you expose me in front of people? No. I want you made feel like go in depth of your heart, feeling of guilt that you defied many people. I want to tell you from me, I'm the source of purity. I'm the covering person to you. Cover your sins. But I love you. Don't worry about your feelings. Don't worry about your rules. Come to him. Come to me and you will be made well. That's amazing, our Lord. When we come to Him daily, without tools, without thinking a lot what people can say about me. Don't worry about people, just worry about one, about your sin. And don't worry that His love has covered multitude of sins. His love will cover multitude of sins. In Book of Luke chapter 7, the lady, a sinful Jew, known in the city that she's sinful. But she said, I will go there, and I have a flask of fragrance, very expensive. I will go and pour it in his head and wash. I lived in sin many years. I want to repent. I want to come back. I feel ashamed for myself. I want that to be purified. I want to live the life of holiness. I want to come back and live into. I want to restore my purity. That's why she went, and she kneeled down at the feet of Christ and poured the fragrance with her tears, washing his feet, and poured the fragrance on his hair, in his head. And then Simon, with there and the people there, he said, the reasoning between yourself, you don't know, he doesn't know who this lady is. She was known in the city, well known in the city, that she's a sinful woman. Yes. And then the Lord, he looked at her, and she felt that she's shy. And people accusing her or condemning her, judging her. And then the Lord said, Simon, I have something to say to you. He told them a story. This is not the end of the story. Now we focus what she was doing there. No, but he want to get the distracted people from what she's doing, to get the shame and get the shyness away from her, and to be what he's focusing. To get the shame, to get just shy, to get the judgment of people away from her. That's why he told Simon, I have something to you, someone that had two debtors, one was 50 denarii, one was 500, who loves him more? And said, I think he forgave all of them, but the one he has 500, I think he loved him more. And said, this is the thing, this thing she did to me. I came to your house, you didn't give me anything. But since she came and she started washing my feet, what he was doing there, he was his love, covered a multitude of her sins, and get the shy out from her, and get the people who are accusing her and judging her, pay attention, don't focus on her. Let her do what she was doing. And this was the concept of Christ. Love covers multitude of sins. That's why, my beloved, today is a quite the same question to us. If you love someone, what do you want to do for him? You want to expose his shortcoming and his weakness, or his sins, his mistakes, his problems, or you want to cover him? Or you want to cover him? That's why in Proverbs, he said, he who covers transgressions seeks love. Who covers transgressions seeks love. Which one comes first? It's because love. You love, God loves us, so we cover all our sins, our mistakes, our problems, our shortcomings, our shyness, our nakedness. If you really have it with love, this is what we need to do. To cover others' mistakes, to cover the nakedness of others, to cover the problems and shortcomings of others. If we want to be like Christ. And it's amazing in the prayer of thanksgiving, which says, let us give thanks to the beneficent God, the merciful God, and then what? Who covers us? Who covers us? So, When you want to cover others' problems, others' mistakes, others' sins, it's realize that God covers your sins first. This is as equal rights. God covers my problems, my mistakes, my sins, so I have my obligation to cover others. Because if I uncover others, God will uncover my sins and my weakness. Is that fair? If I expose others' nakedness, God will uncover or expose my nakedness. And if really we have a true love, that's what we need. That's what we need to cover others' shortcomings, others' problems, others' nakedness. So this is a true love. That's why our practice today. Just think who really you want to cover. Just think who you want to be there for people in their wicked, in their weakness, and to be there for them. Start this week and see if you in your life, dealing with people, family, and work, friends, neighbors, just seek to cover others' shortcomings. Why? Because that serves me. Love cover multitude of sins. Love cover multitude of sins. If you expose someone, you don't love him. You don't love him. That's why we need to pray for this. Reality, we need to pray really deep in this. And we appreciate that you cover our sins, our shortcomings, our nakedness. Let us alone and help us to cover others because of love. Because of love. إنجيل النهاردة أو رسالة بتاعت الكاسيليكون تقول المحبة تستر كثرة من الخطايا. المحبة تستر كثرة من الخطايا. زي ما قلت كده في الأول إن ربنا عن فكرة الخلاص كلها لما آدم وحواء طردوا وسقطوا حسنوا معجنين. فكان الوسيلة الوحيدة بسرعة أن يعملوا إيه؟ أن يغطوا نفسهم بسرعة. راحوا دوروا على شجرة التين، خدوا كده ورا شجرة التين غطوا نفسهم، لكن للأسف وقع الشجرة، وقع الليفز دي وقعت. ربنا قال لهم حاولتوا بنفسكم تغطوا عيوبكم، تغطوا العوي بتاعكم ما ينفعش. فعمل إيه؟ فكذب وغطاهم بجلد حيوان. ليه؟ عشان يغطي العيوب. ليه؟ عشان يغطي المقص. ليه؟ عشان يغطي العري. عشان كده ليه ربنا خلق آدم وحواء؟ خلقهم عشان محبته. الحب تجسد في خلقة آدم ليمتع آدم بحضرته، ليمتع آدم بكل الخليقة اللي عملها قبله. لما سقط آدم ربنا حب يعمل ايه؟ كمان يغطي على عيوبه ويغطي على عيوبه. وبالتالي هي رسالة الخلاص كلها أو أن الله المسيح يعمل إيه؟ يغطي على عري الإنسان، مش بذبائح ومش بجلود حيوانية، بل بدمه شخصيا. عشان كده عظيم سر التقوى كان أن الله ظهر في الجسد. ليه؟ علشان يغطي عيوبنا. مش عيوب، موضوع أكبر من عيوب. يغطي عيوننا، يكسونا بكساء برداء البر. قولوا ليه رب عملت كده؟ عشان ايه؟ المحبة تستر كثرة من الخطايا. في نشيد الأنشاد يقول أن مياه كثيرة لا تستطيع أن تطفئ المحبة والسيول لا تغمرها. أن أعطى الإنسان كل ثروته، ثروة بيته، بدل المحبة تحتقر احتقارا. اعمل كل حاجة، قدم خدمات زي ما انت عايز،
لكن بتعلي الناس، لكن بتكشف عورة الناس، لكن بتركز على عيوب الآخرين، تتكلم على عيوب الآخرين في كل مجلس وفي كل قعدة، نتكلم. فبتعمل إيه؟ أنت بتعلي الناس، بتعلي الناس. عجيب إن ربنا يقول لرب الشكر نشكر صنع ذات أنه سترنا، اللي بتعلي الناس وربنا مغطيك. لو الناس اكتشفوا عيوبي، لو ربنا شاف بس ستره عليا كده، اتفتح. لكن ربنا محبته مغطي على عيوبنا وعلى عيوننا. عشان كده في المرأة اللي مسكت ذات الفعل في يوحنا 8، الناس كلهم بيقولوا كده، بيقولوا تعالى ولا في بعضهم يمسكوا كلمة. هذه المرأة أمسكت في ذات الفعل، ماذا نفعل؟ خلي بالك موسى قال لنا نرجمها، أنت هتقول إيه؟ لو ما خلاص قطع عليه الخط يعني يفكر تاني، موسى قال كده. فلو قال ما نرجمهاش يبقى ضد موسى. لو قال نرجمها في محبته للخطاة. ربنا عمل حاجة حلوة خالص، كلنا بنفكر بطريقة مختلفة. ربنا قاعد على الأرض ابتدى يكتب. ابتدى يكتب خطايا على الأرض. بس هو ليه نزل على الأرض؟ ما كان قال كده. ما كان قال الخطايا بتاعت الناس. ليه ربنا نزل مخصوص؟ نزل إلى الأرض يعمل إيه؟ ليستر على هذه المرأة. ليستر على هذه المرأة. عشان يجي في الأخير لما ما منكم بلا خطية فليرميها أولا بحجر، ابتدى الناس تمشي. كله لما الأرض تطوف في الأرض. بعد المسيح ينزل من السفر لها، مش وشك ابنها كده، أين هم الآن؟ اللي بيدينوكي أما دانك أحد؟ قالت له لا، ولا أنا أدينك، اذهبي ولا تخطئي أيضا. اذهبي ولا تخطئي. يعني ايه ده؟ يعني عمل ايه ربنا هنا؟ بعد الناس خلاص مشوا خالص، قفل كده وكلمنا بينه وبينه، حد دانك؟ لا مفيش حد دانك. خلاص انا هعمل ايه؟ استر عليك. المحبة تستر ايه؟ كثرة من الخطايا. محبة تستر كثرة من الخطايا. بنحب بعض. علامة الحب والستر على بعض. مش بنعدي بعض. مش بنعدي بعض. إن الله الذي ستر علينا يطلب أن نستر على آخرين. وإن لم نستر على آخرين صعب. صعبة الكلمة. إن الله يستر علينا. صعبة الكلمة زيادة. إن لو لم نستر على آخرين ممكن ربنا ما يسترش علينا. يقول لك في أمثال: من يستر معصية يطلب المحبة، ومن يكرر أمرا يفرق بين الأصدقاء. يعني يكرر أمرا؟ كل ما يكون في حتة يقعد يتكلم 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 يتكلم، كل ما يروح مجتمع يتكلم يتكلم يتكلم، يعمل يكرر. بتعمل إيه أنت؟ أنت بتفرق. أنت لا تطلب المحبة. ولو نطلب المحبة جايين ليه؟ جايين ليه الكنيسة؟ عشان نقول لربنا استرنا وغطينا بمحبتك. طب ما انت مش قادر تغطي اخوك، ربنا يغطيك ازاي؟ جايين الكنيسة عشان ناخد غطاء بر، كساء بر يروي يغطيني. هو ده المحبة. عشان كده يقول البغضة تهيج خصومات، لكن المحبة تعمل ايه؟ تستر كل الذنوب. مش حاجة وحاجة، لا، المحبة تستر كل الذنوب، كل الذنوب.
عايز ربنا يستر على كل الذنوب اللي عندك،
استر على مقاطع الاخرين،
غطي على عيوب الاخرين،
غطي على عيوب الاخرين.
ما نحتاج اليه اخوتي ان نفهم ما هي المحبه حقيقه، ما نحتاج اليه هو ان نفهم يعني ايه المحبه تسأل كثره من الخطايا. انت ما تدهش بس بالرؤيه كده، ادخل كده في اعماق وراجع نفسك كده كويس قوي طول الاسبوع اللي فات،
طول السنين،
طول الاسبوع اللي فات، كم مره سترت على عيوب اخرين وكم مره فضحت عيوب اخرين؟ كم حد فضحك انت كمان؟
عشان كده اخواتي مش هنركز على النقطه اللي فاتت، هنركز على اللي جاي. خلينا كده نمثل كده تدريجي عشان ان كلنا نتعلم ونقول ان نستمر بالمليانين بمحبة الله، نستمر على نقائص بعض، زوج زوج يكفر يغطى عيوب الاخرين بعض، اصحابنا واصدقائنا في الكنيسه وفي المجتمع بتاعنا نغطي على عيوب الاخرين،
نغطي على عيوب الاخرين. حط في ذهنك كده مين اللي هتيجي تقف جنبه، زي ما المسيح وقف كده مع المرأة نازفة الدم وغطى حتى على خجلها، مين هيجي كده قدام المرأة الخاطية كده ويعمل يطلع الحاجات الحلوة اللي فيها؟ ربنا عمل كده على السامرية، طلع الحاجة الكويسة اللي فيها. بطرس لما أنكر المسيح، عجيب أن يقول لك ونظر له يسوع، تذكر الكلام وصاح بيك. إيه نظرته؟ مش نظرة عتاب، مش نظرة عتاب، أو مش نظرة دينونة، كانت نظرة كلها حب، كلها حب. ودي اللي رجعت لك. حتى يهوذا اللي خانه يقول لك عمل كده وغمس اللقمة وأعطاها أكلها له. يعني ده بيدلعه قوي، بيدلعه التلاميذ اكيد، اشمعنى هنا هو اللي بياكله؟ بس في حاجه ربنا عايز يستر على عيوبه، حتى على الخيانه. المحبه تستر كثره من الخطايا. صلي كده يا رب من فضلك، يا من سترت على عيوبي، يا من سترت على عوني، على نقائص، علمني يا رب ان اسكت على خير. علمنا رب دين هذه المحبة الصادقة لنا كلنا.